mean boundary layer characteristics, wind and flow. Again, just now we talked about the variation, the diagonal variation. Now we talk about the these three things. So airflow or wind flow or wind can be divided into three broad categories. There's the mean wind, there's the turbulence, and there's the waves. So this is going right into the concept of wind. So far, you've only been exposed to the wind in terms of meter per second. You don't talk about the details of wind. So winds are actually made up of these three things. There's the mean wind, turbulence, and also the waves. In the boundary layer, transport of quantities such as moisture, like say water vapor, even heat from the surface, momentum, friction, pollutants is dominated by, it's dominated in the horizontal by the mean wind, and in the vertical by turbulence. So how these things are transported, this moisture, heat, momentum, pollutant is transported by the horizontal, by the mean wind and also turbulence. If it's in the horizontal, moving from here to somewhere downwind, it's the mean wind or the average wind. But then if it's vertical, moving upwards or downwards, it is transported by not the mean wind, not the ones moving in front and back, left and right, but by turbulence. That means the wind that goes up and down. Now, the magnitude of the vertical turbulence and the horizontal turbulence is it's quite large. For example, the winds could be 10 meters per second horizontally, but then the vertical turbulence is about 1 meter per second, about 10% of the mean wind speed. So if Malaysia's wind speed ranges is about 1 to 3 meter per second, so the vertical movement of air is about 0.1 meter per second. It's about more or less 10%. But this small vertical velocity speed has a very big impact on how the winds, how the pollutants are dispersed. Now, this graph shows the separation of the three categories. The mean wind is like this. Notice it's fairly stable and progressive, increasing progressively without any large changes. This is turbulence. Smaller values, but notice that, okay, for mean wind, zero up to a certain value, and there's an average there, right, above zero value. But for turbulence, you notice that the average is zero. Because there could be positive 0.1 and negative 0.1, positive 0.2, negative 0.1, and so on. But then the average of this positive negative value would come to zero. So it is a variation from the center of zero. Now, wave is something that we see, it's embedded inside the wind. So sometimes you see gusts of wind. Okay, you have a period of strong wind, and then suddenly there's no wind, and then there's a period of strong wind again. So that general pattern of wind, the gusts and the low winds and so on, that is called the waves. So actually this wind that you experience consists of these three things. There's the mean wind, there's the waves, and also there's the turbulence within the wind itself. This one carries the mean wind and the waves carry the carry the pollutants horizontally, but the vertical carries the turbulence carries the pollutants or the moisture and so on vertically. Now we go a bit into the mathematics of this, but this is something that you might have been exposed to, this concept of laminar and turbulent flows. So let's try to calculate the Reynolds number, a number that can describe whether the flow in the atmosphere is laminar or turbulent. So we calculate the Reynolds number using this equation. U is mean wind speed, L is length, horizontal length, and V is kinematic viscosity. So usually we use this Reynolds number inside to assess the degree of the type of flow inside a pipe for engineering purposes. Maybe the flow inside the pipe is laminar, or flow inside the pipe is turbulent. So if laminar is generally slower in speed, and then it's separated into layers, you can see the different layers, and then the layers have the same velocity. But if turbulent is more turbulent, where the profile will be something like that. So if you use this example here, for flow in a pipe of diameter D, experimental observations show that for fully developed flow, that means flow that is, you see, when you exert a force on a fluid and it flows down a pipe, it takes some time for it to be stable, the flow type to be stable. So for a fully developed, after that means assuming that the flow has already been developed, laminar flow occurs when the Reynolds number is less than this value, 2300, and it starts to become turbulent. When the velocity increases, it starts to become turbulent when it's more than 4,000. So in the interval between 2,300 and 4,000, laminar and turbulent flows are possible, the transitional flows, depending on other factors such as pipe roughness and flow uniformity. So let's say we try, this is for a pipe, right? Let's say we use the same concept for the atmosphere. So in the air or in the atmosphere, if we take L as 1 meter, that means it's an arbitrary value. We don't say that it's going to 100 meters or 200 meters. Just say that it's for 1 meter. Wind speed is about 0.1, which is fair to say, because winds are not that strong too in the atmosphere. But the kinematic viscosity of the atmosphere is this, 1.46 times 10 to the power negative 5. That means how thick the air is. The air is not really thick, right? It's very light, so that's why this is very small. And when we calculate, use this value, put inside this equation, say L is 1, U is 0.1, this is V, not exactly V, this is mu, I think. It's a Greek letter. Is this value, and you put inside here, you calculate RE, you get 6,000. 6,000 is more than 4,000, right? So, it's much higher than the critical Reynolds number, and we can classify the atmosphere to be very turbulent. So, we use the turbulent regime classification to classify the type of flow there is in the atmosphere. So, that's why we focus on the turbulence flow instead of any other flow in the atmosphere. Whatever the case, it'll always be turbulent flow, because the kinematic viscosity of the atmosphere is very low. So even though wind speeds are very, very low, it'll still be turbulent flow. So we don't use the laminar type of, the laminar equations or anything to study the laminar, but we just use the turbulence. So we forget about laminar, we just focus on turbulence.